Hello everyone. So in this video, we will use Gunsmith method to transform our bases to a orthogonal basis corresponding to that. So but let us recall the Gunsmith method first. So we'll start with a set of given vectors which are linearly independent. So let the vector be called as v1, v2, to vn. Now these are linearly independent set of vectors. Now we want to transform it to a set of vectors which are orthogonal to each other, pairwise orthogonal to each other or mutually orthogonal to each other, and further we want to transform it to its orthonormal. So we have to divide all those vectors with their norm. So we want to make an orthonormal set of vectors u1, u2 to un such that the span of both this set will be same. So such that the span of this v1 to vn is same as span of u1 to un. And what are the more properties we have here? So ui, uj, the inner product of ui, uj is 0, whatever the inner product we are considering. So in general, in practice, we are considering dot product as the inner product. So ui, uj is 0, and moreover, the norm of each vector, norm of each ui is 1. So this will be an orthonormal set of vectors. Orthonormal vectors. Okay, so what we do here? So for the first vector, we consider w1, the new vector, and the first vector is remains same. So we consider w1 to be our v1. Now we have to make it orthonormal. So our u1 should be w1 by norm of w1. So we basically normalize this vector. So the norm of u1 is 1. Now for the second vector w2, we take v2 and subtract the inner product of v2 and u1, and we multiply it with u1 and subtract this from v2. So this is our second vector. Now if we calculate w2 u1, what we will get? So you will get v2 u1 minus v2 u1 into u1 u1. Now the norm of u1 is 1, we know. So this inner product of u1 and u1 is 1. So we get v2 u1 minus v2 u1, and that is 0. So we get a vector which is orthogonal to u1. Now we have to make it normalized. So our new u2 is w2 by norm of w2. So this will normalize the vector. Now for u3, what we have to do? For u3, we have to take v3 and we have to subtract this v3 u1 into u1 minus v3 u2 into u2. And so on. So for each step, we have to do this same process. So we have to using the vectors which we already get, and we have to use those vectors to calculate the new vector. So our u3 will be w3 by norm of w3. So this is the procedure. Now let us take a set of linearly independent vector and try to calculate the corresponding orthonormal vectors, orthonormal set of vectors. So at first I am considering the set 5, 5, 5 and 0, 5, 5. So these are my set of linearly independent vector. So this is my v1 and this is my v2, and I want to find u1 and u2 such that they are orthogonal to each other, and moreover they are orthonormal. So for the first vector, w1 is same as v1, so it is 5, 5, 5, and so u1 is w1 by norm of w1. Now norm of w1 is basically square root of w1 and w1, the inner product of that. So this is our norm of w1. So if we calculate this, if we take this inner product and we are considering it as dot product, so our norm of w1 is nothing but square root of 75. So this is 5 root 3. As it is 25 into 3, so it is 5 root 3. So if I want to calculate u1, this is 5, 5, 5 by 5 root 3. So I get 1 by root 3 into 1, 1, 1. So basically it's 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, and 1 by root 3. I can take this 1 by root 3 out and I can write this as 1 by root 3 into 1, 1, 1. Now we have to calculate the second vector. So second vector is w2. So this is v2 minus v2 comma u1 into u1. So if you calculate it, so our v2 is 0 comma 5 comma 5, and I have to calculate the inner product of 0 comma 5 comma 5 with 1 by root 3 1 1 1, and this is again 1 by root 3 1 1 1. So if you do the calculation, you will get minus 10 by 3, 5 by 3, and 5 by 3. So this is our new vector w2, and you can check that this w2 is basically orthogonal to u1. Now we have to normalize it. We have to calculate the norm of w2 and divide w2 with it. So we have to calculate the norm of w2 first. So norm of w2, if I calculate it, I will get this 100 by 9 plus 25 by 9 plus 25 by 9. So if we calculate it, we will get root 150 by 9. So it will give me 5 by 3 root 6. And so the new vector u2 is nothing but w2 by norm of w2. Now w2 is, we have already calculated w2 and norm of it. So if we do this calculation, we will get 3 by 5 root 6 into minus 10 by 3, 5 by 3, and 5 by 3. So we can take 5 by 3 out and it will cancel up. So we will get 1 by root 6 minus 2, 1, and 1. So our set of vectors, our u1 is 1 by root 3, 1, 1, 1, and our u2 is 1 by root 6 minus 2, 1, 1. Now if we calculate this u1, u2, you will get 0, and if we calculate the norm of both the vectors, you will get the norm is 1. So we really get an orthonormal set of vectors corresponding to our v1, v2 from which we have started. So this is the method which is called the Gram-Schmidt method, and by this algorithm we can transform any given set of linearly independent vectors, we can transform it to an orthonormal set of vectors. Now let us try to see this in GeoGebra. So we have started with a vector 5, 5, 5 and 0, 5, 5. So these are two vectors, as you can see here. Now what we have done at first, so we have normalized the first vector, so it will give me a unit vector. Yeah, so you can see the unit vector here. So if we zoom, this is your unit vector along the first vector. Okay, so let's zoom out again. Okay, now we have to find a vector which is orthogonal to this unit vector, or rather the first vector. So we get this orthogonal vector. So this is the orthogonal vector we have calculated. Now what we have to do, we have to normalize this vector. So again we will normalize this vector and we will get a unit vector along that direction. So if we again zoom in, you can see there is a vector. Now these two vectors, these two normal vectors, normalized vector, are basically orthogonal to each other. So yeah. And if you see the plane passing through this vector, so this is the plane passing through this vector, so span of all these vectors are basically the same plane. So this is the vector space generated by all these vectors. So the Gram-Schmidt method, by Gram-Schmidt method, we basically find a new set of vectors which are orthonormal to each other, but the spanning set remains the same. So what are the new orthonormal set of vectors here? So if we only see those vectors only, so we can see that we delete all these other vectors. So we will, these two are the orthonormal set of vectors which we get, and this is the spanning set which is the same as the original one. Thank you.